Last year, 1,284 injured servicemen and women were flown to Birmingham's Selly Oak Hospital with life-changing injuries. And for this ordinary couple, a chance visit sparked the beginning of an epic journey.
We walked into a ward full of 30 or 40 young men who were terribly injured, and I think that was the moment.
I'd never been to a hospital and met anyone who's had amputations. I found it quite shocking, actually. Incredibly moving, very emotional, and I thought, my God, you know, here are we, we're fine, we've got nothing to worry about. I think it was the moment we felt we've really, really got to, sorry, I always get a bit emotional about this bit. We've just got to do something. We both thought we've got to do a terrific fundraising event. We've got to raise a huge amount of money. And that was the moment. We just never looked back.
And Help for Heroes, a fundraising charity for our wounded, was born. The first event saw 276 people hit the road to raise money for a swimming pool at Headley Court, the military's rehabilitation centre.
Well, I think we had the most incredible selection you could possibly wish for on a bike ride. We had, obviously, the team from Headley Court, who were completely inspirational and utterly brilliant, and humbling again to see them, you know, get on their bikes and go up the same hill as we did.
And not only did the event raise £1.3 million, for some, it was an extremely personal journey.
The bike ride was a great opportunity for me, and I come along at just the right time. I hadn't even been blind as a year, and I had a lot of thinking to do and a lot of tests to myself to prove to myself that I could still do these things and that I'm still a man. I'm still manly, do you know what I mean?
It was just about anyone and everyone, but the main aim was to raise a lot of money, which they all did.
But this was just the start. Our unsung heroes were inspiring the hearts of millions.
We've had the rugby match at Twickenham. That's 52,000 people came, £1.4 million raised. Then you've got the sort of the rugby players and the sportsmen. So that they're starting to spread the word. And you see Lewis Hamilton wearing a wristband and Lawrence Dallaglio and Martin Johnson and so on. And then you've got the people who are thinking about James Bond. And it's just, it really is magic. I mean, how it's all just sort of spread.
Every day we think, well, OK, maybe the money will dry up today. And then Amanda, who runs all our donations, says, no, it's been another great day, you know, 50 grand came in today. And we can't believe it. I mean, it's literally been an average of between 20, 30,000 a day since we started.
What we're doing is great big lumps of money squirted at places which really need it.
And let's not forget the X Factor, which is well on the way to raising over £1 million to improve the lives of our injured troops.
I am very, very proud and honoured to be a part of it. I have never seen such a public display of affection, and you make me very proud to be British.
I think we are incredibly proud of the way people have just taken up this idea and run with it and done such a brilliant job doing it. I mean, we feel kind of humble, really, because I think all we did is put our hand up and said, right, we want to help. Does anyone else want to help? Great.
To people who started these charities, then I just have to say thank you. Thanks that you're there, because if you weren't, then life would be so much harder. It really would.